Okay, so let's continue. Now, this is a different probability density function than what we have seen before, right? This is a two-dimensional. These kind of distributions are known as joint PDF, okay? Joint probability density function. Similarly, PXY, this was joint. But previously, we were using like PR, PFI. These are known as marginal distribution functions, marginal PDFs, okay? Now we have a joint PDF, okay? So some joint PDFs can be separable and some joint PDFs may not be separable. So a joint PDF is separable if this can be written as P phi PR, okay? So in this case, this means it's a separable joint PDF, but you cannot write this for everything. Some joint PDFs are not separable, but luckily the PDFs that we will be dealing with are separable. But anyways, let's go back here. So we have here CR. Now one property of PDFs which we know, I think, at this point is they must integrate to one. Okay, so if we take this PR phi and d phi dr, okay, so from 0 to 2 pi and from 0 to r, this should integrate to 1. Okay, now let's compute this. Okay, so let's let's clean this and write cr from this result. Okay, now let's get rid of the first integral. This first integral is, you can see, it's just d phi from 0 to 2 pi. So it's going to evaluate to 2 pi. Okay? So I will clean this. Okay? And I will simply clean this also. And I will write 2 pi here. Okay? So we have 2 pi. Let's also put the c outside. It's a constant. So this is 2 pi C R dr is equal to 1. Now let's proceed with the integration. This is 2 pi C R square over 2. Let's cancel this out. And then R 0. Okay. This is equal to 1. So if you do this substitutions, we are going to obtain pi C R square is equal to 1. Okay, so pi c r square is equal to 1, and from here we can see that c is equal to 1 over p or pi, I think I should say 1 over pi r square. Okay, now what does it mean? We have found the following. We have found that the for uniform probability in the Cartesian domain, the probability in the polar domain is equal to 1 over pi r square. So let's write this as follows. It's equal to r divided by pi r square. Okay? So this is the joint PDF that we must use. Okay? Now, in order to sample from this joint PDF, it really helps if this is separable, okay? So if we can actually write this as follows, if we can write the joint PDF like PR phi is equal to PR P phi, okay? It's going to be really helpful. These are, each of these are marginal PDFs, okay? This one also. Now they must also add up to one, okay? They must also integrate to one in their own domain. So if you actually go ahead and write this as follows, okay? So we have r divided by r square, and here we have 1 over pi, right? Now if you say this part here is equal to P phi and this part here is equal to PR, This is not going to work. Well, this is correct, but actually these don't integrate they don't integrate to one in their respective domains. Okay? So actually, if you integrate this from 0 to 2 pi, it's going to give you 2, right? Instead of giving you 1. So to correct for this, we write 2 here and 2 here. Okay? Now you can verify yourself that if you integrate this one from 0 to 2 pi, you'll get 1. And also if you integrate this one from 0 to r, you will get 1. Okay? So this gives us that the probability of r is equal to 2r divided by r square. Okay? 2r divided by r square. And the probability of phi is equal to 1 over 2 pi. Actually, this is what we have used exactly previously, right? When we were like intuitively deriving the PDFs, these are what we have used. Now, once you reach this point, you know PR and P phi, you can do this 3-4 step process. You compute the CDF, you invert the CDF, and you plug in your, basically you plug in your random numbers to get the sample values, okay? So, and if you do that, which we have already done before, you will get this result. So, to summarize, if you sample a disk, okay, using this sampling equations, you will be sampling non-uniformly in the polar domain, but you will be sampling uniformly in the Cartesian domain, okay?